Hi, I'm David DeSerto on the red carpet here at the Fulton J. Sheen Center for Thought and Culture for a special New York screening of the new film Risen, starring Joseph Fiennes, that guy. I read that when you read this script, you immediately knew you wanted to be part of this film. Can you talk a little bit about what was so appealing?
Yes, well, our director, Kevin Reynolds, a huge admirer of his work, so I felt I was in really good hands. Secondly, an incredible story, very arresting for me when I grew up, the story of Christ. But the really big takeaway, or a couple of takeaways for me, and I hope for the audience, is that we get to visit this story through the eyes of a non-believer. So we come at it very left field. And in that way, it doesn't come across preachy. And in fact, in many ways, it comes across more as a sort of noir Bible detective story. And I thought that was really fresh. And also, it's uplifting, because stories that portray the story of Christ end on the cross. And you're only halfway there if you're at the cross. So it's great to see a movie that challenges the audience into the second part of the equation, which is the resurrection.
Could you talk a little bit about what inspired you for writing the story from the perspective of a skeptic?
Right, well, that was all point, was to see it from another standpoint, another set of eyes. So it'd be, you know, this is a story we all know, and so this was a fresh way into the story, to see it from someone that doubted. So that, rather than just tell the story, let him experience the story and like their clues, as opposed to chapter and verse.
The scope and scale of the picture was done by design and leaning on the prior masters of Ten Commandments, you know, in Ben-Hur, where if shot correctly and with the right people, you can maximize your dollar to get a big-looking picture. Also have it be dramatic and action-filled and have serve a purpose, you know, of delivering a message. As for the financier, working on the screenplay for quite some time allowed us to get it into a position where a financier would recognize its potential. And certainly an underserved market.
I read in one interview that one of your fellow producers identified you as the driving force behind this production. What was so important about this film for you?
You know, it was really important to me. And from the very beginning, this was always an idea that I had, that I was like, I really want to tell a resurrection story. I love the idea of a redemption story. But I've seen it so many times with so many Bible movies that are great, but I'd seen it before. And I actually grew up on the Ten Commandments and The Robe and Ben-Hur and all these great movies. And it had been a long time since I'd seen one of those Hollywood movies that felt big in scope and great, but really told a cool story. So that was really the driving force that I wanted to do it. And obviously, you know, after Passion, I thought there was room for another movie, because that was a crucifixion story, to tell the resurrection. I think that was really important for people to see. And so that started the journey, and it's been a long journey, but a lot of people have come along with me. It's been really great. My family's Christian, lives in Oklahoma, and I was really, really worried about not getting this right. Like the other movies, they were like, you can, whatever, if we don't see it, that's fine. But I knew everybody would see it, and it was really important, and I thought the material was deserved for us to get it right. It really did. So we showed it to so many people, and pastors and priests and, you know, everyone all over the world we've shown it to, and really gotten their feedback. And so when we really had the final film, which is ready now, we feel really strong that it is the right film for right now.
I mean, we've seen a lot of movies about the crucifixion, and we've seen some stories about Mary. I think this story, what we were trying to create with this story was really a message about hope. And the way to do it, we could have done it the old-fashioned way, which is tell it from the apostle's point of view or Mary's point of view or whoever that was in the Bible. But I think doing it from the point of view of a non-believer is just a way in.
I have seen two things which cannot reconcile. A man dead without question, and that same man alive again.
Wagering eternity on it.